Hello tips and many more from your 20 civil engineering student from Tasman University, home of the Barbara Festival. And of course, in this episode, you know what? Bus lanes, physical distancing, and other safety or health safety measures that has to be observed, but not always in this case. And without further ado, let's get this topic started. Errant motorists, errant motorcyclists clog the bus lane as part of another bus lane sweep that has been executed recently, or yesterday rather. Buses get blocked not supposed to drive over the bus lane, especially in this Philippine Highway 1, Asian Highway 26, 4th Circumferential Road, also known as the Epifanio de los Santos Avenue or EDSA, whereas buses must be of higher importance for commuting purposes and still on the trial for the city bus route ECO, also known as EDSA Carousel. It has been started ago, or years ago rather, or so many years ago, as MRP, Bus Augmentation Program. And also from Cubao all the way to Antipolo, there's a similar bus augmentation system. And by the way, MRT would mean Mass Rapid Transit. And don't be misled by those technicalities that would cause confusion, especially to those engineers better. And also, you're not supposed to misuse the LRT when it refers to the line 2, which is used as a heavy rail by the technical definition. And let's go back to the safety tips. If you're going to drive, whereas the busing system, do not ever try enter into restricted lane, especially this bus lane, whereas buses are only allowed in that restricted lane, so as to promote the commuting for all Filipinos struggling to get into the work. Whereas the general community quarantine has been implemented. And right now, as you can see in this slideshow, as you can see on this slideshow, the bus lane assignment that has been implemented is on the leftmost lane. It's no longer at the what is supposedly be the old bus lane, aka yellow lane. It's now being converted as a further bicycle lane, sidewalk, wide lane, or motorcycle lane, or otherwise stated by the MMDA. Leftmost lanes, be it one or two, could be used by buses. You are able to watch the live stream of Colonel Nebrija's mobile patrol from the MMDA. And by the way, for the correction sake, it's the MMDA NSA traffic SAR for clarification purposes. And of course, non-contact apprehension is in effect. No entry on all motor vehicles, motorcycles at the leftmost lane. And if caught, will be charged for restricted lane offenses, in which there would be huge fines, demerit points. So you have to be careful while you are driving, read those signages, and if it says buses only or bus lane only, you have to keep off. Motorcycles and motor vehicles have been summoned for violating such bus lane rule. Not even the police and ambulances got spared from the ire from Colonel Pong Nebrija. And I'm worried about what's happening here on the next few days until 22nd June 2020 for further phase 2 implementation of the bus rationalization or bus route rationalization, whereas you could no longer be suffering from such overloaded buses. All bus routes have been organized already into 30 bus routes plus one to make it 31. And don't forget those safety reminder. If you're in a public place, kindly observe the face mask policies. You have to don it. Otherwise, you could be denied entry. And make sure that you're healthy and you're feeling well, especially if you're about to enter those buildings, you have to undergo temperature checks. Individuals, bayan. 37.4 degrees Celsius will be the night entry. And of course, don't forget to follow the physical distancing guidelines, such as not following too close to another individual on the queuing, which is said to be either 1 to 2 meter distance. And don't forget to follow those markings. Failure to do so will cause the widespread transmission of the disease, especially the COVID-19 and other viral or bacterial diseases. And this sums up this episode. Of course, you might need to be reminded always to be safe, be strong, and be well. Take care always, wherever you go. The government will strive to protect its citizens like us as well. And this concludes Durable 24 in Focus podcast episode. If you like it, don't forget to press the thumbs up button or click on the heart button. And of course, don't forget to share, like, follow, and subscribe on this Durable 24 social media pages on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Don't forget to listen to Durable 24 in Focus podcast on Spotify, iTunes, Anchor.fm, and most podcast providers. And also, don't forget to tune in to the FIS SM Dasmanias online every Saturday, 1800 hours. Of course, this podcast is possible with the help of Anchor.fm. They are very grateful for those who are starting up with the podcast. And of course, this podcast is being inspired one of our partner podcaster, Sister Joyce Spring Trevino, is now married already to Brother Juan John Trevino, collectively known as Juan Choice. Hopefully, after this pandemic disaster, some sort of limited meetup, or should I say, a new normal with the Zoom meetings, with the SOS fam, Feast fam, and of course, one of my crush that has been found. One of you're going to answer this clue. It's all over the previous episodes of the Urban Focus podcast could be found. Anyways, this has been your Urban Focus.